Hi, country music fans, and welcome to the 1970s as we head back to one of the strangest decades in history.
Okay, Houston, we've had a problem here.
This is Houston. Say again, please.
Yes, sir. Houston, we've had a problem.
Crazy new fashion, the gas crisis. Funny things happening at a hotel in Washington, D.C. Well, we cover it all. We kick it off by going back to 1970.
As the Apollo 13 was some 205,000 miles from Earth, speeding toward its rendezvous with the moon scheduled for tomorrow night, the fuel cells that supply it with electrical power suddenly failed.
And we also have a problem with the vertical stabilizer on this old TV. Another big story from 1970 was the dawn of the jumbo jet in aviation as Pan Am took the first 747 on a flight from New York to London. Dr. Marcus Welby had the number one TV show in 1970, and the top grossing movie was Love Story. We had so many great country hits in 1970. Here are some of the best.
Yes, darling, you're gonna need me again. It's just a matter of time.
Hear the whisper of the raindrops blowing soft against the window. For the good time.
You're walking on the fighting side of me, running down a way of life, or fighting and it fought and died to keep. If you don't love it, leave it. Let this song that I'm singing be a warning. When you're running down my country horse, you're walking on the fighting side.
This huge country music classic was released at the end of 1970 from Lynn Anderson.
I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden along with the sunshine. There's gotta be a little rain sometime.
Lots of future country stars came into the world in 1970. Happy birthday to Christian Bush, member of Sugarland, Gary Lovox, lead singer of Rascal Flatts, Miss Shelley Wright, and the late Kevin Sharp was born in 1970. But what song spent the most weeks at number one in 1970? Well, that honor belongs to Conway Twitty.
Hello, darling. Nice to see you.
It's been a
Are you happy?
Hope you're doing fine. Just to know it means so much to me.
Yes, 1970 was an incredible year in country music, but 1971 was also a year to be remembered. Charlie Pride owned the country charts and had his best year in 1971. The storyteller Tom T. Hall had a big year, and it was so easy to love Mr. Freddie Hart. We'll see you again in 1971.